chrome through. Cause mascara, mascara, my biggest error, error. Never been clever, clever. Don't force it, fairer, fairer. Because you'll never be me, that's what the Bella. Gigi, Dolce, Gabbana, DG, pretty.
Hi guys, welcome back to Audrey's Artistry. I need a little thing so I'm using. But thank you guys for returning to my channel. I hope you are ready for this new tutorial. Because you know we're under quarantine right now. So why not play in makeup? So this look today is the Pink Me Please monochromatic pink look. And it's inspired by this cute pink little neon teddy bear from MakeupRevolution. It's actually a palette, guys. So we're actually going to get into this look and while reviewing their new concealers. If you're familiar with the OG concealer, Revolution, Makeup Revolution Concealer, Concealing Define Full Coverage, this is the OG. Okay. Now we're going to review New Mama Belle. Okay. So this is the Infinite Longwear Concealer Crease Proof. But it's still the Conceal and Define, but it's the infinite version. And it has a 16-hour wear. So I'm going to test it out to see how long it lasts. Unfortunately, I did not record like my ending results on how long the concealer lasts. But I will be posting it on my IG. So if you're not following me on IG right now, go ahead and follow me right now. Okay. So I will let you guys know my results there. So let's get into this tutorial. I'm not gonna have you too long. See you in a minute. All right, so let's get started. So first, I'm gonna start with my Mario Badescu spray. Spray, spray, spray. And then my Urban Decay Crimping Prime spray. Your girl likes to be good and moisturized. And we're gonna take our Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I literally love this primer because when it says it grips, it really does grip the product. And it's hydrating. It's not like a mattifying primer, but it's perfect. And when my pores are a little bit bigger, I use a different primer. Like the the Tatcha Silk Canvas. That's what I use when my pores are bigger than normal. But today we're gonna use the Hydro Grip. And then we're gonna take the AA Collection Luminous Drops by your girl. If you have not already, check out my cosmetic line. It's pretty dope. And it has top quality products. I put my heart and my soul in my products. And I just wanna show you guys, like, look at the Luminous Drops. So I applied these. I'm gonna stop. So I applied these before foundation. Or you can actually put them in your foundation. Whatever strokes your boat. And the brush I'm using is by Revolution Pro. It's the Pro 260 brush. Love it, love it, love it. So now I'm going to take my Urban Decay Stay Naked foundation. It's an 81 WY, so that means warm yellow. Definitely recommend that foundation line because it comes, you know, most foundations you only get one undertone. So if you're like me, you have like a little funny color, and you require multiple undertones, I love those foundations. It's so weightless. I don't use much of it. Be sure to look at the skincare video. Once you have, you know, a good skincare routine, you don't have that much to cover for coverage. Unless you just like a full beat look, because sometimes I like that full beat look. But I like to be light with my foundation, heavier with my concealers, if that makes sense. This foundation is darker because I actually got fitted like when it was warm outside. So that's why. All right, so now we're going to take the new Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealers. So we're going to give these a try. They gave me 6 colors. So we're going to try to figure out which color I need. All right, guys, so I'm going to apply my gloss. This is Single by the AA Collection. And then we're going to start swatching our concealers. Single is a great everyday clear gloss. If you haven't got on the train with the Single gloss, baby, I don't know what to tell you, because it's A1, okay? And I'm not amping it because it's just mine. The formula is just bomb, okay? All right, so C16 looks really, really warm. Really warm. Like a warm, could be like a contour shade. We can try to use it as a contour. So that was C16. C17 is deeper, of course. This is like a warm red concealer. Has some red in it. And now this one would be more so my contour shade. This is C17. So that's more like a warm neutral kind of color. So I would probably use that as my contour. So let's put that to the side. C13.5. So that's C13.5 right there. That's a cute concealer color, actually. It's like a new pinky kind of undertone to it. C13.2. Okay, that's like a more of a warmer color, more orangey. And now C12.7. So, baby, your girl is gonna be snatched if I wear this one. So, this is the range. So, we're gonna contour with this one here. We're gonna highlight with this one and put like a dab of that one. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So, let's start highlighting. Ooh. I don't like the smell of them. Long wear crease proof. Oh, okay. Crease proof. It better be. Concealers. So that's what it looks like. So the colors I'm going to use the highlight with is C13.5. That's going to be the first color I put down. And as you can tell, it's like a little pinky undertones to it. Well, it's not too pink. It's like a neutral pinky kind of undertone. It's kind of matching my chest a little bit. So, I would want to actually go a little bit brighter. But I think this will help since my foundation is darker. Bring, you know, my color back into play. So that's what I usually use my head and top it with the C12.7. So we're gonna brighten up under here. How I feel about that, I tell, but I'm a little nervous about this concealer because I'm mixing these colors to get my color. So I think I was going to use C17 to do my contour. Let's see. Yeah. So C17 we're gonna contour with. And it may not be dark enough. I don't think it's dark enough, guys. It looks like it's blending in a little. Can y'all see that or not? Yeah, this is pretty, pretty close to my skin tone. So, I don't know what I'm going to do. So let's just go ahead and just blend our concealer out. I'm not sure how it would do with the brush blending it out. So I'm just going to take my beauty blender and a damp beauty blender and blend the concealer out. I can tell it has dried down a lot. And maybe it shouldn't dry down this much. Or we shouldn't allow it to dry down this much. Because I can tell it gets a little dry when you let it dry down. But honey, I am looking a little snatched under the eye already. And I'm really making sure I get under that eye because it claims to be, you know, crease free. Good by mixing those concealer colors together, because it seems like it balances right out. That's what it's looking like so far. Of course, you know, I would like more of a brightness, a little bit more brighter. This is giving me very pinky, kind of warm, neutral concealer. So now I'm going to blend that contour out. I'm taking the butt of the beauty blender and I'm just going to blend that contour out, which is looking like it's just acting as like my foundation. And I'm still going to take my RCM no color powder because I'm dealing with high pigmentation today, a lot of fallout from some eyeshadow, so I'm going to actually set this under eye. I don't want it to fall on my face. And then I'm going to go ahead and contour. I'm going to contour using the Black Radiance Contour Powder palette. This is in medium to dark. And I'm going to use this to contour with. So let's blend that on in. If you notice, I do not like doing my makeup with my wig on because the makeup gets all in the hair. It just gets every freaking where. So to prevent that, I'm just going to wear this hair tie thingy. Alright, so our brows are done, honey. They're done. So now we're going to take our P. Louise base in the number 2 because we're dealing with bright neon pink today. It's pink. This base, and I'm just going to buff it on my lid. Because this is the focus area of the pink, okay, on my lid. And I'm going to create the illusion that my lid is pretty much bigger than what it is. So I go up into my crease a little bit. So. And we just really want to concentrate that product in this one central area. Okay? See me? One central area. You don't want to mess up your nose contour because you've already taken your bronzer up into above your crease area. So you don't want to mess that up. This cute little baby. This is the Makeup Revolution toy play palette by Revolution Beauty. And it has these cute, super cute neon colors in it. And so, you know, we're doing the pink. So we're going to focus in the pink right here. And basically, I'm using this as like a starter color, like a build up pink color. And I'm going to use that to basically buff out the crease area. Okay, so we've done as much as we could with this color. It's not doing it for me, you know. So we're going to take the Makeup Revolution Forever Flawless Birds of Paradise palette. So it's this cute palette here. It's perfect for the springtime, summertime. It has all these cute neon colors. So cute. And so, you know, we're going to go in with this pink. Oh, see, it's very pigmented. So we're just going to tap it all over the lid like so. Now, this is the payoff I was trying to get. Okay. I love it. And the brush that I'm using today is the e.l.f. Fluffy Eye Blender Brush from e.l.f. You can get it from your local drugstore. It's in the brush number. It doesn't have a number. It's just the e.l.f. Blender Brush. So this really is making me feel like I should do like a pastel look next. Would you guys be down for that? Because this palette is really giving it to me. And it has these cute oranges. And look at that blue in there. You see that blue? And the yellow. And the seafoam green. So cute. So that's the pink. I'm trying to see if I want to take a little bit of my pigment, neon pigment, to just, you know, really intensify it. Let's see. Should we? This is going to be extra messy. So let's, yes. Oh yeah. I'm excited about putting that on there. Yeah, it definitely intensifies the pink. Just making sure the focus area is my actual lid. So I'm tapping, and then when I get towards the edges, I'm pulling it back towards the center to help blend it some up. So basically, we're going to take this same pigment, and we're now going to take some more of that P. Louise lace, and we're going to put on our bottom water lash line, because why not just pink it out, you know what I'm saying? That P. Louise base down here. So you have learned this trick from me. If you watched my makeup and wine live makeup class that I did the other day, I love to put this under here for when I have a color in my waterline, because it holds on to the actual pigment. So we're going to go in with first the eyeshadow color in Vacay. So I'm just going to basically tap that color onto the waterline like so. Well, not on my lower lash line. So I'm tapping to get the most color payoff. So now I'm going to take that same brush and I'm going to take it into my neon pigment. And I'm going to tap it a little bit closer to the waterline. Like so. Alright, so we looking real pink, real fierce right now. Real pink. Like, extra-ly pink right now. So now I'm going to basically dust this off so we can remove all that fallout that we had. So now my fallout is gone and now we can begin the rest of the face. So we're going to, my face looks so matte. Come on, concealer, you was cute. Yeah, this concealer is kind of cute. Okay, so now we're going to warm up our face with Mocha Mommy. We're going to use that bronzer by Fenty. We're going to take Mocha Mommy. And I still have some of those luminous drops still popping through, okay? It's still like, hey, we're still here to play. So we're just going to warm up the face. And this is exactly why I don't keep my a blush. And we're going to take the Juvia's Place palette. And we're going to take this color Ada. It's like a reddish, brownish kind of with a little orange tint to it. And we're going to place it on our cheek like so. Alright. Baby, this concealer got me so snatched. I ain't never been this snatched on that. Yes, I have, but it's very, very mattifying. And I'm creasing up on the sides. So you all know that I did take that concealer on the sides of my mouth, like right up in here. So that tells me that homegirl, it creases. So I'm gonna set my face because of course I need to make sure that your girl is even, okay? So I basically take my Studio Fix Plus powders and just, all right, so I'm so matte. I'm more matte than I usually like to be. So got to rejuvenate myself using my Mario Badescu spray, because honey, his face is real matte, like extremely matte. So I use that to let everything blend in and come back to life. And I'm actually going to start covering up some of the spots on my neck. If you haven't been here, you know where I got them from. If you have, I just like to take a little dusting of powder to put down now. Alright guys, so we're back. The hair is dead. Nice little wig from Kia's Hair Boutique. Tell her Audrey sent you. So this is the finished look. So the lip we have today is by Fenty Beauty. First, I went in with a brown chestnut lip pencil. My camera died, guys, when this happened. So I went in with the brown chestnut lip pencil first. And then I went in with Unlocked. And it really wasn't giving me like that neon pink that I wanted to give me. So I went on top of it with Fenty Beauty Tropic Tantrum. Love these. Love these. So these are my favorite from them. Because it's like a stick. And it's just so perfect. So perfect. And so I went on top. So I went on top the other color with this one. Which set it off. I'm giving you real. It's Barbie. Which I wanted. I wanted to be Barbie. Okay. So I just got to give me a cute little outfit. And give y'all real Barbie tease. Okay. But anyway. So that is the complete look. Now we're going to add a little highlighter. And I cheated a little bit. I put a little bit on before I hit record. But we're going to take a new Secret Honey from the AA collection. And we're going to spice this up just a little bit. Just a little bit. And I make sure I set my face. So I did notice, like, I did take the concealer around my mouth area. And it is starting to crease a little bit in the smile lines. Even though this concealer got my face a little snatched, okay? But I don't know how true are we going to say it's crease proof, okay? But it seems to be holding up very well so far. So that's the complete look, guys. Got my little earrings from where did I get these from? I think I got these from Pretty Little Thing. So these are my earrings from Pretty Little Things, and my hair from Kia's Boutique, Kia's Hair Boutique. Yeah. So thank you guys for watching this pink me, please, makeup tutorial, this pink monochromatic makeup tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the review of the concealers, as well as enjoy playing in the Makeup Revolution palettes, eyeshadow palettes. Some of their eyeshadow palettes are bomb, like Pigmentation bomb. Like, I really enjoyed this palette. I think I'm going to play in it some more, so be on the lookout for that. We're going to play in some more. I'm really thinking about doing a little pastel look for you guys. So I'll see you next time. Peace. Oh, and don't forget to like me, comment, and subscribe. Bye.